Hello everybody, they call me Muse and I welcome you back to Hitman Freelancer and the Civvies Only Challenge. I'm pretty sure, up to date, we've actually stuck to the challenge. We have not harmed any guards that weren't our targets. We're on the home stretch now, so let's see if we can continue to do that for the final four missions. Where are these missions taking place? Well, one's in Marrakesh and that's alerted, so we'll probably start there. Still haven't made up my mind, but probably Haven for the showdown. I like Haven. Marrakesh first, we've got poison target dart gun, silent takedown rare melee, unsilenced pistol kill. Have we acquired any of those items yet? We do have the dart gun, good. Don't think we've got a rare melee though. But we'll have a look. Definitely got some unsilenced pistol kill. Options. So it's silent takedown, rare melee. So it won't count if it's a kill, so we can't use any rare quick draws. Is that rare? That's rare, and it's melee. So we can bring a baseball bat. Sadly, we don't have any sort of baseball bat related prestige, but we've got Epic Sub and we've got one of those. And then let's see, that gives us most of the gear we need, I think. Do we bring along two pistols? A silenced one? And then an unsilenced for the other challenge? The classic baller. Yes, let's bring our full loadout to Marrakesh and see what happens. It's been a while, Marrakesh. I've missed you.
Now, she told me something.
Now, house built on sand? Because that guy's having a conversation about a fortune teller. Targets are... Well, three of them are in and around the Shisha Club. That's interesting. One of them is Munchies. There is a way of easily taking out Munchies without anyone really noticing. If we time it right. And if it's a version of the map where it can be done. So maybe we'll head over there first. Because I know he moves around a bit and then he ends up sleeping on a bench. I assume he does that on every version of the map that he shows up on. But it's part of his routine. Let's see. He goes over into the corner somewhere. Yeah, he comes over here. Now, which way around is he coming? And is that guard going to do anything for us? There are people there, so I'm wondering if this is a version of the map where we can sneakily take him out round here, because I've done it before. No, he's coming back this way. Oh, recorded by a camera. That's not the end of the world. Or did I lure him over? Maybe I did that last time. But yeah, over here somewhere. I've knocked him out in the past and got away with it. So let's watch his movements. The three in the Shisha Cafe can wait. So it's coming through here. It's all very busy. Maybe a sneaky dart gun shot will be required for our friend, but then we might need those in the cafe to separate people from the crowd. If we're concerned about such things. Okay, coming down here, or are we just stopping there? Okay, we're stopping there. Is anyone watching us here? He's having a smoker, so we could potentially sabotage that thing, but I don't know if he'll be coming back. Sorry, so yeah, we'll just ping him there with the dart gun. And now he'll hopefully go to the Shisha Cafe toilet. Oh, we've got another target just over there, sat out here. That should be fine though. Although she may go into the loo every now and again. I'm sure some of the NPCs sneak into the loo every now and again. But let's act fast. Bonk. And let's conceal that. Now, Epic Sub. Let's pop him in a box and take his clothes. We are now Munchies.
Common
So let's see, this is going to count as a civilian disguise, I think, so it should mean that our targets... Yeah, they're not onto us. So where are you going, madam? And are you going somewhere where you can be sneakily taken down? Is she going to do this loop every time? Is she going to carry on or is she going back? So many questions. What a mysterious woman. She's coming this way. Does she walk across that?
Good day to you, sir.
She does. She stands in that puddle. Is she the only one who would, though? Because if she is, then that's potentially an option for a kill. But we don't want to accidentally catch a guard in it. But yeah, she's going back now. So we'll just make sure that no guards come this way. Yeah, I'm going to say it's fine. Oh, wait a minute, here comes a guard. So, where's he going to go? He just walks up there and chills. Okay. So now it's just a case of, can we shoot that without anyone getting too excited? The answer's probably yes. Cool. That's now a puddle of death. And I think that's target two taken out. So let's go back to Shisha.
Hey, missed threads, buddy.
There are going to be places around and about where we can get an invitation, but where they are,
snail soup.
Not a 1,000,000% sure. There's some keys to exit the level, so we'll grab them. There's no invitation just sat on there. There might be one over here. Lovely. Pretty much got away with that. Well, we did get away with that. So now we should just be allowed to waltz right in. There's no frisk, I don't think.
Oh no, buddy. You're not coming through here. Sorry.
What? I got an invite and everything. Dang it. Right. Target 2's off on a stroll again, so she's going to fall down in a minute. What if we change back into our regular outfit? Then we'll be spotted if we go in, though. But it sounds like we'll be trespassing if we go in as munches. So maybe we try it. There goes Target 2.
Good day to you, sir. I'm coming to you. Invite, please.
I don't care if
here is my invite.
You're running a charity here. You're dragging me away from a very...
Alright, good job, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. And in we go. So, our targets will now recognise us because we are just us again. There's a couple of guards in there, but we can't hurt guards. There's another target. So he goes in and out of his little room. And that waiter... comes and goes from over here. Yep, we know our target's been eliminated, thank you. Now, will it be waiter who... Well, waiter came over, didn't he? He came over and he looked in this area. So let's pop our briefcase on the floor, and then all being well, he'll be the one who comes back over and sees it, and then he's going to move towards it to see what's up. And then what are we going to do with him? We haven't got any stabbers about our person, so we could wrench him and crunch him. I mean, we don't even need to be in that box, do we? We could stand out here somewhere. That might be the safer option to avoid getting spotted. Because we want to sneak up behind him. And if we come out of the box and he's side onto us, he might get wise. And then we also want to think about how we're going to get our unsilenced pistol kill. So I'm thinking we climb up onto the roof and we shoot our target from up there when he's over there. doing his thing. Wait, it's doing a full circuit, so we'll just hide outside. Potentially we could also seeker it, because if we're just going to shoot target 4 in the head. Just let me know if you need anything. But this should also work. He's going to come in here, he's going to be like, huh, a briefcase. I shall move out of view of everyone else. There he goes. Down he goes. And in the box. So far, so Silent Assassin, basically. But not for long. Not with Unsilenced Pistol Kill on the menu.
Hey, you. Far enough.
So shall we drop our briefcase on the floor down here, perhaps? Oops, that's the wrench. And then up we go. I do worry that people are going to know where the shot came from, and they're going to get all excited. But maybe not. Not if we fire just one shot, perhaps. Alright, people are kind of spotting us from up here, though. Who was spotting us there? Because if anyone's half spotting us, and then they see us pull the trigger, then we're instantly going to be spotted. But if we're in just the right location, we should be okay. Huh? Yeah, people are kind of seeing us and then slipping away again. Alright, there's our man. So yeah, we're kind of being spotted. No, we're not. Okay, we may have got away with that. Do we just stay up here? Gunshot was heard, but we can't be seen up here. It's possible that people are going to come down, although they're coming round, perhaps. So maybe we make a move. Yes, we'll make a move. And maybe we'll just sit in this box for a minute. Everyone's very excited, and we don't want to run into someone on the way out. And our escape options are limited here. Yeah, that guy, for example. He's edgy and he's got a firearm. He is not our friend. Where is the safe? Is it in... Yeah. It's in the room with the security cameras and whatnot, so... Maybe we could get it if we get the waiter outfit back on. The one that we've got sat in another box on our dead friend. Yeah, maybe we will be able to rob the safe on the way out. See how things go once everyone calms down. There we go, everyone's filing back into the club. They've realised they're not the target, and so they're all just chilling now. So let's slip into a waiter outfit. That'll give us a few enforcers, I have no doubt. But it will let us do our thing. So are there any
I left a tip. Leave me alone.
Scanners out here that we need? Or are they all going to be in this office? And we are allowed in here as a waiter, aren't we? Good. Even though guards have taken it over for the purpose of security camera stuff, we're still allowed in. That's two scans, nice and fast. Oh, there's a key. We'll take that. Increase water flow. I guess that's a way of killing the big boss.
Where is the goddamn client?
I forget his name. The guy that Mateus Matthew is meeting? I think that's the other guy's name. It's been a while since I did House Built on Sand. Although it is generally one of my favourites of the bonus missions. Mostly because of the big old changes that were made to the level. I like it when they do something drastically different. Now, is tablet out here perhaps? Oh, here it is. It's in the toilet. I'll have to try and remember that. It's within a reasonable distance of the safe itself, so I'm not going to complain about that one, but it was kind of tricky to find. Now, we've got two guards. One roams around out there, the other one sits down there. So we need that guy to turn his back to the safe just to be on the safe side. Safe side? Huh? Yeah? But we also need the other guys to come back in and go away, probably. Because, although, is that the other guy? If he's doing a full circuit, then we don't need to worry about him right now. You're standing there. You're leaving again. Now is the time to strike. It's only for a split second that they're alerted, but nonetheless, we want to be careful. It's our last alerted map of the campaign. We don't want to mess anything up. And the fact that it is the Civvy's only challenge means that if we do mess things up, our only option is to run away from people. As we are not allowed to give them the bang bangs. Let's think. I mean, another science pistol, just to be on the safe side, would be nice. So let's buy it. And we'll also get the chloroform, just because it's another rare melee item, and one that fits in the pocket. Tripwire mine we're not worried about. We've already got a briefcase item, so that will do nicely.
Come back if you need more.
Thank you, friend. Now, where's the delivery truck that lets us flee the level? Got the key for it, so we may as well go with it. Munchies away! Straight into the gate. There's a perfect run to start the day. Now, Carly, you say? So, we've got Dubai, we've got Santa Fortuna, and we've got Haven. Pacify guards unnoticed can't be done. Poison target dart gun will be done. Generally always is. And high target bods could be... It's hit and miss on Santa Fortuna, depending on where people are. Now, time to hide and seek can be a pain on Santa, especially if we're trying to hide target bods. Collateral accident... might not be the worst thing in the world. There's going to be propane around. Silent assassin suit only. Maybe we... go to Dubai instead, and we do time to hide and seek. Silent target takedown with a rare melee. Poison target dart gun. Eliminate guards, SMG. So eliminate guards again can't be done. Unless it happens that three of our four targets are guards. And yes, we will take timed hide and seek. So this time our rare melee weapon is just going to be a chloroform flask that's going to be bashed over their head. And then we don't need a great deal else in the way of special tools. I could bring an SMG just in case three of our guards happen to fit the bill. Highly unlikely, but not impossible. And is there anything else we might want to bring? Oh, we could bring the karma as well. Just cause. Yeah, let's go to Dubai. And we're starting up here. Which is great on a other version of the map. It looks like it might be the Ascensionist, because we've got that guard out there who we've seen before. We've also got that lad. Interesting. Now, so that guy peeks in there. Maybe we just bip him from here? Oh, someone heard that. Did they hear enough to go and investigate? Yeah, they did. Okay, so that's a bot found. Everyone's going to go on alert. Do we work our way across to the maintenance man outfit? Can we do this without getting spotted crossing these hostile scaffolds? Now, who are the targets? We've got a John Doe and we've got a Frederick Munter, so... Where are the two targets of dudes? So they might all be guards. It's hard to say at this point. But we're just going to get ourselves a maintenance outfit because... it's just a jolly good idea. And we'll grab the key as well, because why not? And yeah, because we're just generally in the area, we may as well take out the cameras now as well. And that'll allow everyone else to settle down around where that dead dude is. So what are we looking for? The yellow server thing. And that'll give us access. Also, there's a box containing a flash grenade. Okay. There we go. Disabled cameras. Now, with cameras disabled, our man out here might be a bit more amenable to a kill. Do we prepare a chloroform flask? Yes. Because there's a guy around that corner, but he's not going to see much of anything. Are we allowed outside here? We are, but there's also those two guards, so we'll wait for him to come back in. And then I don't think anyone will see us. Smash him over the head. If he can come in sooner rather than later, then that'd be good, because we do have time to hide and seek. So, where does he stand exactly? There. We're kind of visible, actually, so maybe we move him a touch.
Jeez.
Yeah, Commander, some kind of practice down here.
Oh no, we've grabbed the guy out there. Okay. Oh, he's coming up here, is he? So, I mean, the helicopter pilot might notice something's up. Collateral accident could have been done out here as well. They'll both worry about that, but one of them is a guard, so he's the one who's going to come over. Okay. He's just going to go back to looking at his helicopter. Perfect.
Come on. Well, it's not like I have...
Crunch. Now. So we could put a seeker dart in him right now, but I'm sure we're going to get a chance to seeker one of the other two. So maybe we just do that. How far down are our other targets? Two floors down. That guy's in storage at the moment, so he might be a waiter of some sort. So I'm going to assume that eliminate three guards SMG is not possible. Ah. Okay, guard number two is actually a guard. Amazing. So maybe we just give the old seeker. Just to get that one checked off the list.
Yeah, I feel horrible.
Not me in there, weirdo.
Now, where are you going? Over to the toilets, I assume. Huh?
Ah, hi there.
Yeah, she might want to leave at this point. Is she going to leave? Or is she just going to watch? Okay, she's just taking notes, I guess. So down they both go. And out comes the old subby once again. And we've actually got another silence pistol. Or is that just another variant? Yeah, that's just another variant of the one that you can get in scale, so that's fine. No. You didn't see anything, did you? Amazing. So we can nip back behind the bar.
There's always something to fix, am I right?
And back into our cupboard, where that guy called us a weirdo. And target three is around the garden sort of area, so yeah, we'll just run across the floor. It won't take too long to get over to him. This maintenance outfit might be among... If I was doing a tier list of all the outfits on all the levels and how useful they are, this is an S tier outfit. Limited enforcers, great access, it's just amazing. Having said that, I've just run into two enforcers. But that's fine, perhaps. And of course, yeah, target number three is not a guard. So there goes our perfect run. Is he is he just going to sit? He's just going to sit. That's not great. But he did come from this direction, didn't he? Okay, yeah, there's a bunch of enforcers down here for this outfit. Sadness. Is there a cupboard down here that we could sneakily use? Because he's going to come in to this area over here. And then he's going to be in a position where we can seek him from somewhere without anyone noticing. One would hope.
Pretty swanky place, huh?
All right, so he's over there now. He'll kind of see us. They'll both kind of see us if we seek him there. I'm sure there was a guard in here, but there isn't now. Those guards over there, they might see us if we do anything cheeky. Ah, now he's going over there, though. So, they're both upright. And they're both looking away from me. I could potentially get away with a shove here. But, better to be safe than sorry.
I feel horrible.
As long as he doesn't go to the same toilet and then stumble across some dead guys and start panicking. That would be unfortunate. Nope, he's suddenly got a maintenance key card and he's coming this way. Very good. Is there anyone down here?
Oh, shit, I was going to get the,
Oh, he's going that way to get to the soilers, isn't he? Excellent.
Shouldn't you buy me dinner first?
Cheeky man. No, because I don't think you'll be able to buy us any in the future, what with the whole thing. And there he goes. More enforcers. But that's fine. We're on our way home. Do we need to speak to a supplier? Where would we even find such a thing on this level? Up near where we started, perhaps. There is an exit in that general direction, isn't there? Yep. Looks like the Ascensionist is trying to flee the level, but she can't because the elevators don't work on this version. There will be no escaping for Allison. Let's have a look. They're down a floor, so I think they are over here, and then jump down, and then... Oh no, they are actually on this floor. Okay, so it's this vendor. Right, so we'll finally buy that cheap assault rifle, I think. Just to get it checked off the list. And do we buy a Dax covert? Is that the one that you can get? No, it's the Dax DTI you get from the Dubai Guard. So yeah, we'll buy that as well.
If you need more...
Do you have an aircon to fix or something?
And then we'll drop her here, perhaps. Yeah, I was thinking it was this vendor over here that we were looking for. The one that stands there. But it wasn't. It's fine. Either way, we're going to use the same exit I was going to use if that had been our supplier. We're going to slip out here and jump off the side of the building. Good work, 47. Remote micro taser. Yeah, still kind of more useful than a prox explosive. I'm just not a big explosives guy. I know some people swear by the rubber duckies, but I probably underuse them, but I think other people might overuse them. Maybe. Now, we should be able to do a couple of those challenges at least. We've only got three targets, so they're probably not all guards. Now we've got submachine gun kill, epic. That's perfectly doable. Maybe we don't bring the karma, just on the off chance that we fail the mission. We don't want to lose both our dark guns. So yeah, I think it will keep the loadout fairly simple this time. Maybe, actually, we'll bring the screwdriver along again. It's nice to have a shanking device, and we might want to have to mess with some electrical items. It's not unheard of. Where are we going to take out the cameras if we need to on Santa Fortuna? Where are the cameras located? Yeah, we can silently pistol the one in Martinez's office, so we don't need the EMP device. Do we bring a rubber ducky just for the funds? I was just saying I generally underuse them. bring one along, just in case it comes in handy. Although with high target bodies, it may well not, but we'll see.
Oh, no.
Right, so we've got old P power.
No.
Just hanging about.
No.
We got a target. Over at the construction site. I rarely seem to get targets over there. And then we've got Bella in the town itself. And then we've got one over near the helipad in Franco's hut. So, what would be a sensible way to deal with this? Is it just business as usual? Get the mansion guard outfit. Because that should allow us at the building site. It will allow us in Franco's compound. And it is just lying on the floor, so we can get it without molesting any guards. Maybe at some point I should do a challenge where it's like, don't do all the things I normally do every time. So in that case, it would be a case of don't take this mansion guard outfit. But then again, I did suit only, and that would have covered that already, so maybe it's fine. And I'd have to think of things on every other level that I do every time and forbid myself from doing them. Yeah, that would probably not be a challenge in the future. So, building site. We're in. We're allowed. There are enforcers, for sure. Now, Barnaby does stand in front of this thing, right? We're not allowed to turn it on. But yeah, he did walk in front of that, didn't he? So, if we could get ourselves an outfit that would allow us to tinker with that cement mixer, that could be cool. It could be something different. We don't normally get to tinker with the traps around here. Those two lads haven't heard that, sadly. Oh wait, he's just coming in here. Okay. Maybe there's no need for any exciting shenanigans after all.
This day keeps getting better and better.
Oh, and of course it wouldn't help with high target bots, would it, if we took him out in an accident like that. So yeah, we'll just get our prestige out of the way. And chuck him in a bin. High target bots is pretty restrictive, all told. How are we going to hide Bella? We're going to have to seek her and then hope she goes somewhere like a bridge that we can push her over. I feel like for a large level, there aren't many places where the supplier hangs out. Maybe it's just a quality of life thing. You're always coming through the village. So having a supplier here just saves you having to just run over to, for example, the Shaman's hut just to get a supplier. Now, could get some common guns again. Get the Rude Ruby. Might unlock another silenced pistol down the line. And then do we get some explosives? Or do we just move on? Maybe we just move on. Maybe we'll get that assault rifle.
If you need more.
Although, if this is indeed the final episode of Civvies Only, then that assault rifle, I think, could be picked up from guards at some point in the future, so
see the poster?
Maybe we don't need to buy it. There's Martinez.
Can't believe how quickly I got used to living like this.
And there's Bella. So she's shopping for veg and fruit. These are some nice looking peppers. Is she going to go anywhere interesting? Let's really iron up that corn. That guard is just too close for us to do much of anything. She's gone back to the peppers. Are you just going back and forth? What if we sneak up here? We're trespassing. Is that the end of the world? Yep, that guard can see us from there, so there's not ideal. In here, no one's particularly looking in our direction. So we'll just put a dart right in her bumhole and see where she goes. I don't know if anyone will notice this if we just give her a bit of that.
Whoa.
Oh dang.
Oh,
someone found the pod.
You've been in a horrible accident. I'm gonna get you some.
Was there a box or anything? There wasn't a box. So I didn't really have a lot of options there for hiding the pod. Could have potentially dragged her this way and then got past there. There's no cupboard there, so could have potentially kept dragging her and then I could have dragged her into that box, to be honest, if I hadn't shoved her. Oh well, let's hide target bodies off the menu. We're only going to get 2 out of 4 challenges complete. C'est la vie. 2 out of 4 is better than 1 out of 4. It's better than 0 out of 4. It's not as good as 3 or 4 out of 4. That's how numbers work. Is Franco's hut going to be an issue with cameras? Because there are places where cameras can be disabled, but we've not bothered so far. Could have taken them out near Martin's village when I had the chance, but didn't bother. There's probably cameras somewhere in the mansion. Oh yeah, they're down in the basement, aren't they? And they could be taken out without any guards necessarily getting harmed. But I don't think it's too much of a problem, especially now that high target pods has already been blown. So we've got Franco's hut. We've got a man just in there, just standing. We've got those guys though. Those guys might be a pain in the bottom. Let's see. That'll do. That'll do, pig. Now let's steal a helicopter, which nobody will really mind all that much, I'm sure. And away we go. That'll just leave us with a showdown to take care of. Remote taser, why not? Eliminate leader during tell. Now, I noticed earlier that our target is dehydrated. Eliminate leader during tell is great if you want to give them a bit of the old lethal poison. So maybe that'll be the plan. Because we do still have a couple of poisons that we need to be able to finish the job on one of the challenges. There we go, 23 out of 25. On eliminating people with poison. So a bit of progress on that would be just dandy. Poison target dart gun though is also an option. So maybe we poison them with a dart gun and then we poison their drink and then we just wait around for them to finish bombing and go back to their routine. Hat, brown hair, tattoo, glasses. That's fine. So no earrings, no necklace. We'll bring along our pistola. Only one disguise, so it would want to be, probably, a disguise for poisoning people with a chef outfit or a waiter outfit. It's absolutely possible to get yourselves a chef outfit with no trouble, but it does also have a fair few enforcers around. But maybe that's something we'll consider. Let's have a look. You've got a hat. You've got brown hair. No glasses. You're off the list. You've got black hair, I think. So you might be off the list. We'll just double check though, because black and brown, it can sometimes be hard to tell the difference between. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you've got glasses, but you might have big... Yeah, you've got those big star earrings, haven't you? So you're definitely not the one. Anyone else close by? No. There's a few in and around the cocktail bar. One over there on the beach. Because we also want to consider where our target is going to be drinking. We don't want to get an outfit and then find that our target drinks, say, on Barclay's private island. We're not allowed over there. But the fact that poison target dart gun is an option is good, because that can help us confirm exactly who our target is prior to anything else. Now, are you wearing a hat? You are. That's a tattoo on your arm, though. I don't think that's naturally there, so I think that's been added. And therefore... Oh no, we are looking for tattoo, aren't we? And yeah, it looks like you got glasses, so you're an option. You might fit the bill. Or is that an earring? That's an earring. Get off my list.
Hey there. Need anything? I might have it.
Might you not?
After you.
What do you have? Goodbye the survey, just cause. Also, she's an unusual supplier, I've just thought, because
have a good one, sir.
You're around if you need more.
She doesn't move away and act casual whenever other people are in the vicinity. She's about the only supplier that doesn't do that, I think. It's really annoying when you find your supplier and then they're like, oh, nope, someone else has walked into this bathroom, so I'm just going to start mopping. Yeah. Blondie can get off the list. Who's up here? Red? Yep, you're off the list. There's a couple of other people up here by the look, so... And this would be a decent area to poison people, because we get a chef out quite comfortably. You don't have a hat, right? No hat. You're reading a book. After like a minute, we are down, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, we've eliminated 7 people, and we've got 2 left. One of them definitely fits the bill. The other is over in the mansion. So we're basically already there, because we've got 2 shots of the dark gun. So that will confirm exactly who our target is. The last one appears to be down, actually, in the underground basement area. Which is... a bit unfortunate, but not the end of the world. Now, we will sneak into the mansion. Oh. We'll take out the cameras, because we can do that without doing our usual thing of knocking out a guard. Let's see. Let's line up this shot properly. There we go. Okay, so target is back at ground level in the villa. Which means they might be headed out somewhere. We don't necessarily need like a chef outfit or a waiter outfit to poison our target, but it would generally be nice. I believe waiters might be allowed on Barclays Island. Target's over there. Second one's there. They're just roaming a boot. Don't mind me, chaps. I'm just strolling into the undergrowth. Yep. Oh no, there they go. They're coming our way. Now, how many bills do you fit? Looks like that's brown hair, alright. So you also fit the bill. So we need to watch for a sneeze and a drink. But it looks like he's moving with purpose. He's got that walk they've got when they're on their way to a meeting. We're looking for a handover meeting, so that's another clue that we can use to narrow this down. Another possible target has also left Barclays Beach now. They are actually going over there, which is generally an area where drinks are kept. So that would be nice. I mean, heck, we could also just poison this guy, couldn't move the dark gun. See what happens next. So that card's gone. That guy is not our target. Excellent. Just like that, we know who we're after. And yeah, they've just sneezed as well, so that makes it even clearer still. Although it was already pretty clear.
It was nothing.
It was nothing. It was nothing. now.
Oh God.
Yeah. So this is definitely our target.
Like right now.
She was like having a meeting over here, but there are drinks on one of these tables normally. Well, there's food on these tables. There might not be drinks. Right. Yeah. So if she was a foodie, this would be the place to be. As it is, we're gonna have to wait for her to finish chucking, and then we're gonna have to follow her for a bit and see where she enjoys a beverage. She's gonna be a minute though. So do we get ourselves an outfit? Is it waiter outfit that allows us onto Barclays Island? Could we potentially sneak on right now? Is anyone going to notice? I was waiting for that guy over there to turn around, but it didn't look like he was going to, so... What other outfit would it be if it's not waiter? I don't think chefs are allowed over here. Yeah, that over there. That person is in a waiter's outfit, so if we can get a waiter's outfit, then we can definitely get to where we need to be. Because I feel like where we need to be is possibly over there. It's either over there or it's not. But a waiter outfit will let us get there. Yep, she's done. She's back to sneezing. So we could just follow her now. I spent too long dithering about whether or not we'd need a waiter outfit. And she's just recovered. So we'll just follow her. Okay, although now might be a good time to trespass, because... Yeah. I've actually timed that, okay. Now we're concealed. How would we get into the main body of the island, though? Because I thought it was just straight through here, but it seems like it's not. What are you doing, Lily? This way. The target, that is, not Lulu. She's going upstairs, where there are waiters and whatnot. She's going to have a drink up there, isn't she? It's inevitable. Yeah, there she goes. So she drinks up there. Can we just vault up there? Hang. That waiter's been moving now, though. So he stands there. So he goes back and forth between watching a drink and not watching a drink. There's an armed guard there as well. Oh, are you coming up? Yep, you're coming up, and you're coming through.
Hey, mister!
Dang it.
Who are you again?
Your target is trying to get away. Move.
Why aren't you listening to me?
I'm listening. Right, target's on the move. So we need to be taken. It was going well until that guard went in a direction I wasn't expecting to go in. But there we go. Target down. Now, of course, we've got to get out without getting shot. So we've blown prestige. We are only going to get 2 out of 4 again. But we haven't used any disguises yet, which is cool. Now, can we sneak back in there and grab a waiter outfit to help us escape? That would be nice. We still haven't harmed any guards. Which was absolutely something that could have happened there if I'd panicked too much. Or do we just make a run for it? Yeah, maybe we just run for it. Get on the old seaplane and continue to live our life. So yeah, prestige blown, but we're alive. And any mission you walk away from is at least a moderate success. So we still haven't got those elusive poison kills, but that's fine. We got a Seeger ghost back. which we lost on the failed second attempt at the campaign. But failures are something that just happens in this. You've just got to live with them and pick yourself up and keep on going. And that's what we did, and it all worked out. Next time, I think we might try something a little different. Not very different, but a little different. But I'm pleased we managed to get through this campaign without any accidental guard offings. It was a little trickier, I feel, than the guards only challenge, but they both forced me to think outside the box a bit, and that's the main reason I do these. So I've had fun with it. I hope you've had fun too. And until next time, I'll see you then. Thanks for watching, friends.